Jeremy, can you tell me what kind of a scene we're working today?
Yeah, today we're working on an unattended death of a guest, and was here about 3 weeks before before we got in here to do anything. So,
any idea how the individual passed away?
From what I've got from individuals, is a GI bleed.
Okay.
He's a heavy drinker, and that didn't help at all with it.
So what disinfectant do you guys use?
Rely on.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a multi-purpose disinfectant cleaner.
Okay, Steve, so what did you find out once you took the bed sheets off?
The bed sheets were removed and disposed of, but you can see the mattress cover prevented the biohazards from going down to the mattress. It's got a heavy backing of plastic on the back of it, so that stopped from saturating down through into the mattress.
So now you don't have to do anything with the mattress. It's okay to stay where it
actually,
is?
Actually, the mattress can be saved. It can be salvaged.
Pretty good.
Jeremy, is there a way to tell if there's still blood left over on an item after you've cleaned it?
Yeah, absolutely. You can apply an indicator to it, and that will react to any body fluids that are still present.
Steve, we typically cut out all the carpet in a room like this?
Typically, we will just do the affected area of carpeting that has the biohazards. But in this case, they have asked that we remove all the carpet from the room.
Okay.
So we will take the contaminated portion of the carpet, put it in an appropriate biohazards container, and then we'll take the remainder of the carpet and just take it to a city disposal.
Now, will you bring in a subcontractor to replace the carpet, or is that up to the client?
That is up to the client.